Well, good morning and welcome back to Balfour Farm. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, ring a little bell. Oh, it's icy out. subscribe and you'll get to see our video every time, notified every time we post it. Anyway, I'm headed over this morning to the heifers are mad. I went to feed them and then I realized rather than do that, their feeder from where they were out on pasture, I wanted to move it over to their new heifer barn. So gonna do that first thing. Alright, well I finally got it busted out of the ice. I've been sitting there a while, so the weather has finally changed. It's gonna snow again today. It's been snowing and raining and just being winter-like. So I went to get this feeder brought in, put it undercover. I'd been feeding the heifers. Whew, that's heavy. I've been feeding them outside. So I just dumped their grain on top of the hay bale that I'd been feeding. And it's all covered in snow this morning, so I thought I'd drag this over, and it's a trough feeder. It's seen better days, but my neighbor gave it to me, so he's a retired dairy farmer. Thought I could use it like several years ago, but I have made good use of it. Just get that feeder dragged in. Now they're following me because they think I'm gonna feed them on top of the hay again, which I'm not. While I was in the barn, the coverall barn there, I realized that I had run some wire. I can't believe they did this. I'd run wire in conduit. Hadn't hooked anything up yet. It was to feed the pig barn, and this is what I found.
Hey, get away from that. Come on. Get away from that. Come on. Oh, man. Really? I can't believe. They dragged 250 feet of wire.
I had it all tied up, much neater than this, in the barn. I still can't believe they did this. They must have got a hold of the reel that I had tied up. It was up high. Somehow they got it, yanked on it, pulled it out of, oh, I don't know, 75 feet of conduit. Fortunately, it wasn't hooked any power yet. Unfortunately, I never thought I would have to tie the one end off. But, oh, I can't believe they did this. Come on, now they're stepping on it. Come on, get off there. Come on. All right, we'll get that wire picked up and now I gotta go feed the heifers so they settle down. Now the green truck's here, so that's good. We have pig green and chicken green coming today, so. All right, well, we just finished milking and milking the cows. And I'm out here at the greenhouse right now. I parked the manure spreader in here overnight. We got snow this morning, and then yesterday we had rain and freezing rain and just a lot of junk weather. So I didn't want the spreader to freeze up. What happens is all the ice gets in there and just makes a mess. So then you have to get in there and free it all up. So parked in here undercover for the night. All the tractors get parked in the barn. So anyway, got to hook this up and go down and get some sawdust to load it, or probably two loads of sawdust today for the cow barn. So what I normally do is I normally leave the manure spreader parked down by the sawdust shed. That way I can just take the tractor down and fill it up. It's parked right there. Fill it up and hook up to it. Today what I need to do though is I'm gonna drive down there, unhook it, and then fill it up and then rehook it. Kind of a pain, but it's a lot better than if it were full of ice and snow. Originally, I planned on posting a video today, or Saturday, the day you're watching this, of last night we went down in the cheese cave, Heather and I did, and picked out cheese. We tried a bunch of cheese and picked out what we wanted to put. We're going to put our cheese in the World, I think it was the World Cheese Competition. It's in Wisconsin anyway. We need to send it out at the end of the month. So we went down in the cheese cave, tried a bunch of cheese, and somebody, not pointing any fingers, but somebody didn't plug the microphone in. So anyway, at the end of this video, I'll put some of that video in. There was no audio, so it was just a silent movie of picking out cheese in the cheese cave. So anyway, I'll put some of that video up, and at some point in the future, we still need to, we're going to enter our cheese in the ACS, which is American Cheese Society. We'll enter it in that competition, and then there's a couple more that are coming up. So we'll go down and pick cheese at a different time. But anyway, when you see the, hang out to the end of the video, and you'll get to see Cheese Cave, the Cheese Cave. We went down in and picked out cheese. Unfortunately, there was no audio, so, but anyway. I gotta get this thing hooked up or filling up with snow here. So get back up and bed the cows down so I can get them back out into the cow barn. All right, well, we're just out here to, nope, leave it be. Nope. Come on. Hey, get out of there. All right, we're just out here to scrape down the barn. Bed it down. I need to rototill the pack today. So what I do is, I don't think I've showed you before, but I lure the the heifers and the bull and the calves. The calves are the biggest trouble. The cows would probably be fine. But the calves get in the way of the tractor, the rototiller, the spreader, you name it. They can't help themselves. So what I do is I lock the, oops, there's a pen in the back barn here. There's two pipe gates. So I lock everybody in here. I'll show you. All right, so there they are. They're all locked in. Now I can go through and rototill without having anybody get in my way. Well, we're back out here in the barn tonight. I just finished feeding and watering the pigs again. I just collected eggs. So I'm gonna go in and I thought I'd show you how we wash the eggs. And then I need to crate them up. Load up the truck tonight. Tomorrow is market. And that should be it for the night. Maybe bring some firewood in too, but I'll show you the eggs first. All right, so we're in here washing the eggs, and I thought I would show you how we wash them. We have an automatic egg washer, and I figured I'd show you how it works. It's pretty simple. It's a homemade setup, but it works well. So automatic egg washer, the way it works is what we've done is we take the soap tubs. These are the plastic tubs there that we get our soap in, the same ones that we've actually made hog feeders out of in the past before we cut them down. What we've done is take about the bottom third off the soap tub, and then we have these bubblers. So what they are is they're just made of 1-inch PVC pipe, and there's a bunch of holes drilled in them, and you can see there. And one of these goes in each of the tubs, and they just stick together. And then what we do is we put water in here. And then this here is just a little shop vac. And the important part of this is it's on the exhaust side. So the hose gets hooked up so it acts as a blower, not suction, which makes a huge difference. So this just plugs into the PVC pipe. And what it does is it bubbles through. So it blows air out, circulates. We let it run for about 5 minutes. We can do two separate baskets at a time. Works good, cleans them really well, doesn't work perfect, so we still have to go through and double check them and clean up the odd egg here and there when we crate them up, which we'll see here in a little bit. But anyway, gotta get these filled with water. I'll get the first two baskets in and show you exactly how it works. All right, so I thought I'd give you a close-up view of exactly what's going on here so you can kind of see what that looks like. It has all, stick my finger in there and it makes it mess. You can kind of see all the little holes and the air is gonna bubble up through that. So we just take a basket of eggs, set them in there. Sits down in there just like that. I normally let them sit for a few minutes before I actually turn it on. That way it just, and all these eggs are actually hosed off ahead of time. So we hose them down to get any of the loose dirt off them, and then we put them in there. There you go, clean eggs. So I just have to hit them one more time with the hose here, rinse them, give them one more final rinse, and then we take them in to the other side of the barn here and we'll package them up. All right, so it's the end of the day. This is the last job that I have to do is crating up the eggs. So what we do is have a damp cloth and a dry one. I'll go through and check all the eggs, dry any wet ones off before we put them in egg cartons. Anything that's too dirty, I can wipe it off a little bit. If it's really dirty, I'll set it aside. We'll run it through the wash again. If they don't get washed a second time, they get fed to the pigs and the pigs like them. So anyway, I'll get to it. All right, so I know somebody's gonna ask, probably more than one, but now I'm gonna tell you. They're gonna ask how many eggs we get a day. This time of year, we have about 250 hens, I think. I don't really know. I think there's about 250 out there. And right now we're getting right about 12 dozen eggs a day is what we're getting. So we get about 80, 85 dozen a week. And a lot of them, this time of year, it's tough because it's so cold. We collect eggs twice a day, what I remember, and they will freeze really quickly and then they crack. So maybe you can see over there, there's a basket of most of those eggs that are in there. Most of them are clean, but they were frozen, so they split right down the side. So we lose probably about 10% a day, maybe 9 or 10 eggs. Although, 2, 4, 6, 8, yeah, 10 eggs over there. So not all of them were frozen and broken. One of them I accidentally squeezed it too hard and broke it. But anyway, so that's what we're looking at. The normal, in the height of the season, when things are going really well, the chickens are laying good, and it's warmer out, we typically get about five to six eggs per chicken per week. So roughly, we try to figure, sometimes they do a lot better, but if we can get 6 eggs a week, so half a dozen per chicken, when things are going good and it's nice and warm out. So we have 250 chickens out there right now. They're doing roughly 85 dozen a week. In the summer, when things are warm, they're happy. Everybody's happy in the summer. They would normally be doing about 120, maybe 125 dozen a week on a good week. Right now, it's cold out, there's less light, and some of them have just recently molted, so they're coming back around. So we're getting about 80 to 85 dozen weeks, which I'm still happy with that in the wintertime. So
1 egg shy. If I only hadn't broken that 1 egg. Oh well. That can go in the house. We'll eat those 11 eggs.
What do you think, Moose? Huh? You here to help? Are you my help? You gonna help me?
Well, we're on to the last job of the night. I think I said the eggs were the last job, but this is actually the last job. I'm gonna load up some coolers. It's plenty cold out. It's actually, I don't know if you can see it, it's snowing. So it's plenty cold. We can load the coolers up and we're going to put them in the van with the meat overnight. The dairy products, all the cheese and things like that, we'll have to load in the morning. So those are back in the walk-in cooler. But I can load up all our small coolers with meat. We put ice packs in them anyway. And I can put those in the truck. The reason I'm trying to get so much done tonight is Heather is actually down in, where is she? Today she had a workshop in Portland on food safety, and then Portland, Maine. She went from that to, she drove tonight, she still may be driving, I don't know, to Amherst, Massachusetts, to the University of Amherst. She had there's a conference, a 2 or 3 day conference down there. I think she's only going to 2 days of it. She needs to go down. She's a speaker at the agroforestry talk. So we have our agroforestry project that we're doing, and she's doing a talk about it. But anyway, I need to get the truck loaded. It's already about 7 o'clock, 7:30 at night. So I'm going to get the meat loaded up. And then I'm finally done for the night. Are you here to help? Are you here to help? We're gonna leave. Oh, you know what's in there, don't you? You're not getting a bone tonight.
Nope.
No bone. All right, well, that's it. We really are done now. I just need to go shut the water off of the cow tank. Might not even have to. Yeah, I better do that. Go shut the water off of the cow tank. It's still snowing, as you can see. But anyway, got to get some firewood and head to the house, and I am done for the night. All right, well, that's going to do it for this video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more of what we're doing here on the farm. I need to go fill up the wood stove, and like I promised, I will show you some scenes from the cheese cave. The quiet scenes. We're going to try and film some more down in the cheese cave next time we pick out cheese, and I'll try and remember to plug the microphone in this time. But anyway, that'll do it for tonight. And we will see you next time.